It's been a long time. Okay, so we're gonna skip on formal introductions. I like TV shows. Like, a lot. One of my favorite eras of TV actually happens to be the 1980s. Shows decided to tackle issues that a public conscience might not actually be aware of. And so this is where the term very special episode comes from. And the 80s were chock full of them, let me tell you. We got episodes focusing on the horrors of addiction, pedophilia, anorexia, just to name a few. And I suppose a family-friendly atmosphere is what made them all seem a little less threatening, but these topics were usually treated with as much dignity as they needed to be in order to be understood by a younger audience who might be watching these shows. And one of these shows just happens to be one of my favorites ever, Family Ties! Now, this show has Michael J. Fox in his second television role of his life. And I'll be honest, it's actually pretty good. The good comedy actually outweighs some of the cringe most of the time, so I'd call it a stellar one in my books. I have watched this whole show before because I bought it all on iTunes, and I recently just got it on DVD, so now I'm gonna go through it with a more critical eye. In these brief videos, I'll be covering each of the seasons in somewhat depth, but also very brief. But I'll just be going a season at a time, so there'll be 7 videos in this little mini-series. And so because I watched all of season 1 the other day, we're gonna talk about Family Ties season 1. So, my main issue with Family Ties season 1 is that a lot of the plots in the first half of the season seem very standard. And that, in and of itself, is not a bad thing, because they actually have a few good jokes that make up for it. But all the episodes seem to have a very standard formula. We open in the kitchen, where everything is all jokes and laughter, and then suddenly, boom! Plot hits ya. And then from there, shenanigans ensue, and from there we get a very heartwarming or very emotionally tense climax for each episode. That usually results in one or more of the family members confronting the issue that they had during the episode. And my main qualm is not with the writing for each of these climaxes or each of these episodes, it's more for the fact that it's very predictable. Also, I felt the show could get a bit preachy at times. The first season Thanksgiving episode titled No Nukes is Good Nukes follows Elise and Steven as they go and protest nuclear arms. But you know, like family audience, you have to get a little in their face with the messages. I completely understand that. But you know, the comedy from the very beginning was always pretty good. The funniest episode of the season for me would probably have to be the one called Stage Fright. This episode involves Alex and Mallory on basically a quiz bowl team, and Alex doesn't have much faith in Mallory. And so Alex spends the whole episode training Mallory on what the answers are gonna be and just like testing her on random knowledge, and eventually she gets it. But when they actually get to the televised quiz bowl round, Alex is the one that seizes up and he gets stage fright, leaving Mallory and their other contestant to completely answer all of the questions. There's a really funny moment where earlier in the episode, Mallory had answered this question about the Strait of Magellan correctly, but when she actually gets to the round, she answers it Strait of Massachusetts. And the judges give it to her anyway because they think she's pretty. However, I believe the best episode of the season would have to be Summer of 82, where Alex loses his virginity to a college-aged woman. The title is an obvious play off of the movie Summer of 42, and the plot actually follows it pretty note for note. But to me, that was the most emotionally satisfying episode of the entire first season. This was back in a day where television sitcoms could be much more episodic and they didn't have to follow a storyline through an entire season. However, this also brought its own challenges because you could bring in a character, or the writers could. They could bring in a character to serve a plot convenience and never have that character show up again. That's not a problem so much in this first season because you have characters that show up early in the first season that show up later that cause more problems, and that's fine with me. Also, the other recurring characters usually just happen to be Alex or Mallory's boyfriends or girlfriends at the time. but they usually don't last more than one or two seasons. Overall, I think I will give season one of Family Ties about a B minus. It's still pretty good. The comedy is good, the emotional heights are good, but it's not as satisfying as most of the episodes would be later on in the show's run. And so yeah, here we go. I think I'm gonna enjoy this marathon. I just started on season two today, so we'll see how long it takes for me to get done with that one. This is Dustin signing off, but only for now.